Hi, I'm Peter Travers, the movie critic from Rolling Stone, and what is out there for us to see this weekend? There's two movies, really. The first one, the one that you're hearing a lot about because it's an Adam Sandler movie, is called I Now Pronounce You Chuck and Larry. I'm telling you, people, avoid this like the plague. This doesn't need a review, it needs a stake in the heart. I mean, just to be fast about it, Adam Sandler is playing a super stud, a New York fireman. Kevin James is his partner, and in order to get Kevin James, who's a widower, health benefits, they pretend to be gay. So it's a chance to make every queer joke in the book, get all the laughs you can out of these crude jokes, and then at the end say, that's not nice, you really shouldn't do that. So this is the most mealy-mouthed, hypocritical comedy that I think I've seen at least this year, maybe ever. Okay, what should you see then? That would be Hairspray. I can hear you. You know, anytime a guy I know and I talk about musicals, they say, they're so gay. I mean, musicals are gay. I can't see this one. I just can't, you know. Chicago, gay. You know, Phantom of the Opera, please, I can't go near it. Hairspray, though, is a completely different thing, even though it does star John Travolta in a dress and a fat suit and a kind of Miss Piggy smile. It's based not just on that Broadway musical that's still running, but on a John Waters movie from 1988 with the same title, Hairspray. And it's set in Baltimore in 1962, and it's all about this chubby little teenager who has been shut out of everything and wants desperately to get on the Corny Collins show, which is a kind of American Bandstand dance show, but nobody likes fat girls. They just don't like fat girls. And they also don't like anyone who isn't Lily White. So this is about racism in the beginning of the 60s, and it has something to say in its own funny kind of buoyant way. Well, who's Travolta in this if he's in the dress? Well, he's Tracy, the little chubby girl's mother. And he's a laundress who hasn't gone out of his house because he's been so ashamed of his weight. Well, is that a setup for a musical? Turns out it is. Turns out, even though the director, Adam Shankman, seems to be so relentlessly perky that there were times I thought he gave the entire cast Red Bull to get them through this. I mean, that's a bomb, bomb, bomb all the time. Colors, lights, everything that people call gay. You can't resist it. It's got a fun score, it's got a huge cast, and the young members of the cast are particularly good. I mean, Nikki Blonsky, who plays Tracy, the young chubby girl, who just takes over, is terrific. Zac Efron plays the hero of this high school, who she's in love with, named Link. And he's everything he was in High School Musical. You got Michelle Pfeiffer as the villain. You just, everywhere you turn, James Marsden, you know him? Cyclops from the X-Men movie, Song and Dance Man, and he's good at it. And also, and I gotta give this real credit, it's less than 2 hours long. It's not one of those impossibly long musicals. Not a moment of pain in it at all. Good music, good acting, good young cast. Travolta and Christopher Walken, who plays his husband in this, also do a soft shoe. That's incredible. It's not condescending. Christopher Walken looks at Travolta in these house dresses as if he really, really loves him. You know, sincerity. So you have it all. Here's a way to sing a song along with them called Welcome to the 60s, and the big finale is called You Can't Stop the Beat. Well, you can. It just brings back a period to life that probably nobody even remembers and was never that way in the 60s, and makes you get out of that theater thinking, gee, that was a fun time. You will not have that fun time at I Now Pronounce You, Chuck and Larry. So I now pronounce the movie of this weekend, Hairspray. I'm Peter Travers.